Hello friends, in the last lecture we learned about some important result, and on that result we saw some example, that is the result implication in which the questions depends on that result implication. Write the following compound statement without using if then, and then we use that implication result. Today we are going to learn about important laws. Friends, for these laws you must remember the following table. Write this table from textbook. Now just we are learn this adiabatic law, and this adiabatic law state as P conjunction P equivalent to P. Also P disjunction P means the statement disjunction itself or conjunction itself, we gives itself that statement. After that, commutative law. Commutative law state that P conjunction P disjunction Q equivalent to Q disjunction P means we change place of that statement only. Similarly for conjunction, P conjunction Q equivalent to Q conjunction P. Next, associative law. Associative law again state P conjunction Q conjunction R equivalent to P conjunction Q conjunction R means we change place of the bracket. After that, distributive law. This distributive law state that P conjunction Q disjunction R is equivalent to P conjunction Q disjunction P conjunction R means apply this conjunction on both statements. Similarly for disjunction, if out of bracket there is disjunction, just apply the disjunction on the both statement in that bracket. This is the distributive law. After that, De Morgan's law. What is that De Morgan's law? Negation of P conjunction Q is negation of P disjunction negation of Q. This is the negation of the conjunction and negation of the disjunction, and that negations are called De Morgan's law. Next one, identity law. And this identity law state that P conjunction T gives itself that P statement, and P conjunction F gives that truth value capital F. Similarly for disjunction, P disjunction F is itself that P statement, and P disjunction T is truth value capital T. You must remember these laws: identity, De Morgan's, distributive, commutative and associative. Depends on this law we have to solve the example in the above exercise. Next law is complement law, and this complement law is P conjunction negation of P is equivalent to capital F, and similarly for disjunction, P disjunction negation of Q, sorry, P disjunction negation of P is equivalent to capital T. Must remember this law is called complement, and P conjunction negation of P is F, and P disjunction negation of P is T. Okay, after that, observation law, biconditional law, you must learn this all law, and depend on this law we have to solve the exercise 1.4, in which the question number 3 depends on these all laws, and we have to prove the given two compound statements are logically equivalent. Similarly, this question we solve in exercise 1.2, but in that question we solve this question depends on truth table. Okay, means find the combined truth table and observe the column or this statement, and if the columns are same, then these both statement are logically equivalent. But in this exercise, these questions depends on the laws. Okay, see first question here. What is that? P double implies Q is equivalence to P conjunction Q disjunction to negation of P conjunction Q. So for this, we must consider one side, and using that one side we prove the second side, and we know LHS equal to RHS, then that both statement are logically equivalent. So see friends, here we consider LHS. What is that? P double implication Q. Okay, so by using in that loss table, by conditional law given here, by conditional is equivalent to P implies Q, conjunction Q implies P. Okay, so by using by conditional we write this. After that, use here conditional law. So what is the conditional law in that table? So this statement P implies Q is equivalent to negation of P, disjunction Q, this conjunction as it is, and again implication, this negation of first statement means negation of Q joined with disjunction, and second statement as it is means P as it is. So after that we use distributive law here. So how to distributive law means here negation of P, conjunction Q, conjunction negation of Q, conjunction P. So use here distributive law. So negation of P, conjunction this statement as it is means this bracket as it is, put this disjunction here, and second is Q, and again this bracket as it is. This is the distributive law. So now next, after distributive law we again apply the distributive law here for the first square bracket and for second square bracket. So this negation of P applied to this both statement into that bracket. So negation of P, conjunction negation of Q, here disjunction as it is, again negation of P, conjunction P here, second law or second statement as it is. Now again apply for this second bracket distributive law means apply this Q disjunction, sorry, Q conjunction applied to this both statements, negation of Q and P as it is. So apply this, we get this second bracket. So now which law here? Statement and its negation. Again statement and its negation, and that law is called complement law. And negation of P, conjunction P, we use capital F. Also Q, conjunction negation of Q means statement, conjunction itself, negation, then we use F. So here write down F. So we get here statement disjunction capital F and statement disjunction capital F. So this is the identity law, and that by using that identity law we get statement itself means this first bracket itself, and again this second bracket itself. Now use the commutative law. What is the commutative law? Just change the place of statement means first bracket goes to the second place and second bracket goes to the first place, means we give here this statement. What is that? This P conjunction Q at first place and this negations bracket at second place means we get the RHS, means we get LHS equal to RHS. It means both the statement are equivalent to each other, means this first question prove the logically equivalence is proved. We consider the LHS of this statement and we prove this LHS equal to this RHS, and then that result is proved. So friends, now similarly we again see the example number second. What is that? In example number second we just have this P disjunction Q, conjunction P disjunction negation of Q, and we want to prove this statement is logically equivalent to P statement. So use here distributive law. What is the distributive law? Here P disjunction and P disjunction is same, means we take out of this common, P disjunction is common. So what is remain here? Yes, what is remain? This Q and negation of Q remains and joined with this conjunction. So we write here P conjunction negation of Q. Okay, now again we have statement, conjunction itself, negation of that statement, that law is called complement law, and we get by using that complement law Q disjunction negation of Q equal to capital F. So we get P disjunction capital F. So if the compound statement combined with truth value, then that law is called identity law. So what is the identity law? P disjunction F, then we get itself statement, so we get P. So we prove here this statement is logically equivalent to P, and we get LHS equal to RHS, so therefore that both statement are equivalent. Understand, friends? Now similarly, here question number third. Again, this total compound statement we want to prove it is logically equivalent to P disjunction Q. So apply these law on the statement. Firstly, distributive. What is distributive? Take out of common things out of the bracket and remaining part into the second bracket, and after that complement law. Complement means statement and negation of itself, that statement joined with disjunction or conjunction, and then write that complement law. After that, if the truth value and statement combine each other, then we use the identity law, and then by using that identity law we get this statement. Again, distributive means apply this Q disjunction on this both statement, and we get this both the bracket. Again, Q itself, negation Q, then again complement, and then write the truth value and truth value with the statement, again identity, and we get itself that statement. And this statement Q disjunction P, we use the only complement law, means change the place of statement, means P first and Q second, and then we get the RHS. Okay, like this, by using this distributive, complement, identity, we get LHS equal to RHS, and then both the statements are logically equivalent. If we have given in a question instruction without using truth table, then we must use these law. Means when we can't use that truth table's proof for the without using truth table questions, then we must use these laws, and then LHS equal to RHS, and then that question is solved. Okay friends, thank you. Do practice, and for more questions visit this channel prajpatileducation.com.